What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. Jeremy Scott here. Today, we're going to talk about weight loss. Let's dive into it. Let's first talk about reasons why you might not be losing weight. Then, we're going to talk about some things that you could do to accelerate your weight loss. But before we dive into it, make sure you subscribe down below and hit that like button. First reason why you might not be losing weight. You cannot lose weight without holding yourself accountable. Well, what are you supposed to hold yourself accountable to? If I want to lose weight, what's one of the first things that I'm going to start doing? I'm going to keep track of what I'm eating. I'm going to keep track of how many calories I'm taking in. If you know how many calories you're taking in, then you know what's working and you know what's not. You can't play guesswork when it comes to weight loss. Stop playing guesswork. Stop eating junk. You need to know how many calories is working for you and how many calories is not. If you're taking in 2,000 calories a day and you're not losing weight, guess what? Lower it by 10%. Drop the calories down a little bit. If that's not working for you, drop them down a little bit more. Keep track of your weight on the scale. Hold yourself accountable. When it comes to weight loss, a lot of people say, I don't want to get on the scale because it discourages me. That's because you're not being honest with yourself. If you don't want to get on the scale, it's probably because you know that you're not doing what you need to do to lose weight. If you're doing what you need to do, if you're eating right, if you're meal prepping, if you're doing your cardio, if you're doing your strength training, then you will be anxious to get on the scale because you know that you've been doing your homework. If you get on the scale and you don't like what you see, it's because you're not doing something right. Check off your list. Am I doing my cardio? Am I lifting weights? Am I keeping track of what I eat? Am I setting aside time to meal prep? Am I weighing out my food? These are all the things that you need to make sure that you're checking off of your list. And if you're logging your calories and you're still not losing weight, you might be logging your calories wrong. You might be weighing out your food wrong. So go back and double check for accuracy and make sure you're doing it correctly. If you don't know how to do it, be patient, be persistent, and keep trying. Don't give up and don't quit. You're gonna figure it out soon. You're gonna learn soon. Just like everything else, you learn by doing. You learn by practicing over and over and over. But you can't quit and you can't give up. Another reason why you might not be losing weight. Your heart rate is not in the right zone while you're doing cardio. If your heart rate is not up high enough during cardio, then you're probably not burning enough calories and your cardio is not very effective. Another reason why you might not be losing weight, because you're not weighing out your food. Weigh your food out. Yes, sometimes it feels tedious. Yes, sometimes you don't feel like doing it. Would you try to hit a target with a blindfold on in the dark? No, I don't think so. So why then would you try and lose weight and not keep track of what you eat and not weigh your food out? That doesn't make sense, people. Come on, don't be lazy. I can't stand laziness. Another reason why you might not be losing weight, you're not doing strength training. I've heard a lot of people say, well, I'm just gonna do cardio first to get the fat off, and then I'm gonna start doing weights later. No, it doesn't work like that. When you do resistance training, when you lift weights, what does lifting weights do? Lifting weights build lean muscle mass. What does lean muscle mass do for you? Well, it helps you to burn more calories and it helps increase your metabolic rate. Each pound of muscle burns anywhere from 15 to 50 calories per day, depending on your activity level. So what does that mean? More muscle, more calories burned. More calories burned, it's gonna be easier to get in a caloric deficit. If you're not in a caloric deficit, you will not lose weight. If you're not in a caloric deficit, you will not lose fat. Plain and simple. If you want to lose inches off your waistline, it's not going to happen from a waist trainer.
Oh, come on, man.
If you want to lose inches off your waistline, it's not going to happen from fat burners. It's going to happen from being in a caloric deficit. So if you're not losing weight, the only reason why is because you're not in a caloric deficit. How do you get into a caloric deficit? By holding yourself accountable. Keeping track of how many calories you take in. Increasing your cardio so you can burn more calories. Strength training so you can also burn more calories. You have to do the right actions and you have to do the work. It's not just gonna magically happen by following some fad diet or taking a bunch of fat burners or eating bad and running miles and miles and miles per day trying to outrun a bad diet. It doesn't work like that. You have to make a little bit of sacrifice. You have to be willing to go through a little bit of discomfort. And that is how you lose weight. Stop drinking soda. Stop drinking too much beer. Stop drinking too much liquor. Stop drinking juice. You think it's healthy because it's fruit juice, because it has the word fruit in it? Stop drinking juice. The only thing you should be drinking is water and diet drinks. Diet soda. If you need the sweets, go ahead and drink a diet soda. It's not a big deal. Increase your water intake. These are the actions that have to be done if you want to lose weight. And you have to do these things consistently, day in and day out. Not for one day, not for 2 days, not for 3 days, and then get on the scale and say, oh, I'm not losing weight, this doesn't work. And then go back to your bad eating habits, back to drinking your juices, and back to drinking your sodas and your beer, and eating your potato chips. Stick with it. Stay consistent. You have to be able to stick to a plan for more than a few days. If you're only sticking to it for a few days and then messing up and then going back to it for a few days and then messing up, you're never gonna lose weight. Stop doing fad diet. That doesn't work. Keto diet, intermittent fasting, cleansing, colon cleanse, all that stuff, that doesn't work. That's not how you lose weight. You lose weight by eating the right foods and eating every 2 to 3 hours. If you don't eat every 2 to 3 hours, you're not gonna be able to speed up your metabolism. When you first wake up in the morning and you don't feel hungry, guess what? That means your metabolism is slow. You have to get used to eating breakfast first thing in the morning. You wake up in the morning and you say to yourself, oh, I'm not hungry. I don't feel like eating. I just don't have the appetite. That's just an excuse. If you start eating first thing in the morning, whether you feel like it or not, I guarantee you after about a week of doing that, you'll wake up first thing in the morning and your stomach will be growling and you won't be able to wait till that first meal. That's how you get your metabolism sped up, by doing what you know you need to do. You can't just do what you feel like doing. If I just did only what I feel like doing, guess what I'd be doing? I'd be sitting on this couch right here, eating potato chips, eating ice cream, not eating protein, not drinking enough water, just drinking soda, just drinking alcohol, having a beer because I feel stressed out. You can't just do what you want to do. If you do what you want to do, it's gonna put you in a downward spiral. Focus on the facts, not on your emotion. What are the facts? You say, I need to lose weight. What needs to be done to lose weight? I need to set aside time to meal prep. I need to do my cardio. I need to do my resistance training. These are the facts. Your emotions are gonna say, I hate cardio, I'm craving chips, I had a bad day at work, I don't feel like working out. Set aside your feelings and set aside your emotions and handle business and get done what needs to be done. This is how weight loss is done. Make sure you subscribe down below and hit that like and stay tuned for more videos on weight loss, exercise, diet tips, and recipes. Jeremy Scott, out.